Welcome, everyone. I'm Judy Blumberg to the 2001 Canadian Figure Skating Open. First up, the men's competition, led out by Emanuel Sandhu, followed by Todd Eldredge, Stephen Cousins, Brian Orser, Kurt Browning, and Elvis Stojko. This young skater trains all year round for this particular program. It's the technical program. There are certain requirements in it, and it doesn't lessen the pressure that he's trained all year round. However, this is a different venue. It is judged by International Skating Union judges, and this man is becoming more well-known with each passing season, Emanuel Sandhu. Emanuel was ninth in last year's World Championships and is trained by Joanne McLeod in Vancouver. Beautiful quad toe. Had trouble on the combination part of it, but as you can see, gets tremendous height and had great speed going into the jump. This is one jump you'll see many of the gentlemen doing. Triple axel. Well done. He's very unique in his style, and I think you can tell just by looking at him in the way he presents himself that he's done a lot of ballet and off-ice training. But again, it's about the elements in this competition tonight. Triplets. Can't hit them any better than that. He's got great positioning, this camel. Look at the stretch from his hip to his toe, and he finishes every movement, which you don't often see. And I think that's due to his ballet training. What's really nice is that when the audience engages with you in your program, they've got clapping going and the music helps, plus his movement on the ice helps. He's a good entertainer. He hasn't always had the best performances, but this is a new season and a very important season leading up to the Olympic Games. Again, look at the position, the stretch, even through the arms and the fingertips. And he always does interesting shapes. And I think that gains you a lot of recognition and points with the judges. They don't see the same old thing. Emanuel Sandhu, the reigning Canadian champion, looks to have a great season for 2002. He's innovative, he can do the elements, and he combines it in something that's very interesting. Look at this quad toe. He has a slight 2 foot on the landing and just doesn't get over himself to do this double toe for the combination. That's going to be a slight deduction. But he has great height, great power, and a clean air position and landing position on the triple axel. With his coach, Joanne McLeod, it's not easy to go out first in the technical program. The judges are just assessing where you should be. They haven't seen any other competitors, but he really did a fine performance. It was strong. It was innovative. He did the elements. He could use a little more speed in his spins, but he's got some incredible movement quality in his program. And you can tell they award him great presentation marks. I mean, those are fabulous. It's a strong showing for the first part of the competition.
Thank you.
Especially with so many great men coming up, like this gentleman, Todd Eldredge of the United States. Now, he is another one who is eligible for the Olympic Games, and he's been training on this program all season. This is a really important moment when he takes his time to set himself up to be in the right space to do the beginning. Skating listening to Carmina, Burana by Carl Orff. And you always put the big tricks first. And here is his quad toe. Ooh, and that is a bad fall. He slipped off the edge. He was tilted in the air. That's not a great way to start this technical program. This is where Todd needs to refocus and really hone in on what gets the job done. And he does exactly that on a beautiful triple axle. Todd has a very easy lifting quality about his jumps and his spins, and he actually is one of the best spinners in the world. He has speed and great positions. Footwork right into a triple X. Ooh, which he turned into a double. He is not having a great night. And as far as those elements are concerned. The best thing I can say at this point is that, well, look at the position on the spin. It's so fast and so solid. The best thing, again, that I can say is that these are the kind of performances you want to get out of your system before your national championships or World or Olympic Games. You just keep building your strength and your confidence through these type of opportunities. Very nice serpentine footwork. It's fast. It has variations in speed and in trickiness. He was doing some toe work. He did turns. I'd like to see a little more level change on him, going down on his knees or spiral type movements. Again, watch the speed in this backspin. Todd will take another look at that program and go home and do some work, because these are not the kind of elements he wants to miss when it comes to competitions. It seems that the men who train on this program all year long are finding themselves out here with a little bit of the nervous thing happening, like on that quad toe. Slipped out, he had a tremendous lean in the air, and just didn't get the height. But this one was picture perfect. He got up, he was tight, and he had beautiful flow out on the landing. It's just so clean.
The marks for Todd Eldredge for required elements.
And this is where his miss on that quad toe especially, and the triple Lutz, which he did a double, is going to be reflected. Those are very, very low marks, well below Emmanuel Sandhu. But as you can see, the presentation marks are well up there. He deserves this. He's really worked on his presentation. He relates to an audience. And I think it really shows in his performance. Following Todd Eldredge is Stephen Cousins of Great Britain. He's the 8-time British champion and has now chosen to go into the professional ranks. He is no longer Olympic eligible. He decided the training all year round for that one performance at the end of the year was not enough reward for him, and he was really wanting to explore other avenues in his skating. Now, you might not see the big tricks from this young man, just a double axel. Those kind of elements possibly are not going to compete with the likes of the triple axles and the quad toe. But again, it's who hits what out here. And he is having trouble tonight as well on that triple axel. He didn't really get up and complete the rotation before the jump was due to come down. Thank you. not a particularly difficult footwork sequence, but he relates to an audience. He always has fun out there, and he's really learned to relax and enjoy himself. And I think a lot of that has come from the influence of someone like Scott Hamilton, who he worked alongside with for a couple years. Years, Stephen worked with Doug Lee at the Mariposa Figure Skating Club alongside Elvis Stojko, who was also coached by Doug Lee. Now, this position on the camel spin can't even hold a candle to what Emanuel Sandhu did. He doesn't have the speed, he doesn't have the shaping, or any of the interesting shapes throughout the combination spin, and that's part of what you need on this technical program. All those elements have to be so sharp and so finished. Whoa, I was gonna say, he just seems a little bit slow, but maybe that's as fast as he can go because it's a bit small out there. You saw him hit the boards and kind of put a smile on his face. Stephen Cousins, always enjoyable to watch. Had a couple misses out there tonight on a spin in that triple axel. And this is where he just doesn't get up. Takes a while, and he's right near the boards. He doesn't take that edge, and he really had no rotation, had a not enough rotation to finish the element. Here's the triple flip. He gets good speed into it, nice height, nice flow out. It just isn't one of the most difficult elements. And this is where he's going to be hit hard on required elements. Those marks are really where they should be. Unfortunately for Stephen, he doesn't like them. And he did miss a big one with the miss on the triple axel. Presentation, it should be up there. The program didn't really rise to the occasion. I would have liked to have seen him have a little more fun with it.
Thank you.
Those of you who enjoy skating will love this next gentleman, Brian Orser, the two-time Olympic silver medalist, once against Scott Hamilton in 1984, the other Brian Boitano in 1988 in Calgary. If you'll remember, it was the Battle of the Bryans. Triple toe, double toe. Brian is also a former student of Doug Lee. Already, I feel a real connection with him and the music and the audience. He has really nice focus. You can see his face and his expression. And he's definitely got a connection with the ice. High triple sow, solid. He seems very confident to me. Has always been known for his fast feet. Twizzles, the toe steps, the turns, the jumps, kind of puts everything in that footwork sequence. Thank you. This is also a homecoming of sorts for Brian Orser. He competed here in the 1984 World Championships and was really heralded for his silver medal accomplishment in Sarajevo. I think this building has always had good memories for him, and tonight is no exception. The tricks weren't the most difficult, but he hit each and every one, and up till now, there's not been a gentleman out there that has hit all their elements. So Brian Orser has got to feel great about what he put out there on the ice, how it's received, and let's just wait for the judges' marks, because that's the strongest performance yet. You can see he's so confident on this triple toe. He gets nice height and goes right up into the double toe. Actually, he probably could have done a triple-triple. But he probably didn't want to take the risk. You can see how quickly he moves. Fast feet, speed over the ice, a variation in his steps, and that makes for a good footwork sequence.
Ever.
You can hear him talking. He was pleased with that performance. I mean, you can remember the good ones. And the audiences, they really appreciate that spirit.
Thank you, Kurt. You're the man.
And these two are very friendly. The next skater, of course, Kurt Browning, waiting for Brian's marks. And he knows. He knows Brian did a great program. I think he's right. I don't know if they know what to do with it. His elements weren't the toughest, but he did complete it with a clean program. And you can see four of those judges acknowledge it, but the three are way out of line with those low marks. A 4-4, please.
Very novice man.
At least he can laugh about it, right? The presentation, of course, came up. I mean, he's a seasoned performer. He's been a professional for many, many years, since 1988.
Thank you.
And he loves what he does. The current standings for the men's short program are Emanuel Sandhu in first, Brian Orser in second, followed by Todd Eldredge and Stephen Cousins. There's Donnie Jackson, who was a former world and Canadian champion, watching a former Canadian champion as well, Kurt Browning. And you never know what this guy's going to do. I mean, look at the outfit. He's got a sense of humor, that's for sure. Most of you will recognize this music from all the Peanut specials that Charles Schulz did over the years. And I think Kurt will take it to the end. No matter what he's doing, he has fun. And what he's doing is counting the revolutions in a spin, because you're supposed to have a certain amount, so he was literally and figuratively counting them with his fingers. And the footwork circle. Sometimes you do footwork where you don't know where your feet are going. Again, counting the revolutions. Gotta be patient. Actually, he didn't have a lot of speed on that spin, which might have been easier had he had some. What I'm anxious to see is how he's going to throw these triples in for the technical marks. All this tripping around, it may look easy, but it has to be very well planned, and you have to be a great skater to do things like that so you don't go on your face. So finally, we'll see a jump from Kurt Browning. And it's a triple toe, very easily done, followed by a double toe. Triple sow cow with a nice save at the end, actually. The judges will know that he didn't check out on that. And again, on that double axel, it may be cute for the program, but I don't think it'll be acknowledged as a clean landing. But he sure makes it fun, doesn't he? He laughs at himself. He enjoys performing, and he can still do the tricks when he needs to. Kurt Browning of Canada. Never won that coveted Olympic medal, but he was a many-time world champion. And I think, really, he's grown so much as a performer since he turned professional after the Olympic Games in 1994. There's no stopping Kurt. As fellow competitor Elvis Stojko looks on. You can see he lets his feet kind of go, but you've got to be in control of your feet in order to not go down on your face.
You have my guard?
He's become very versatile in his performance skills. And he's changed a lot about his skating.
How is my...
Oh, this is great. You know, it's so unlike the serious moment. I mean, and he's the one to have one of those moments.
This is serious!
And he said it himself.
Who did that?
You can see he goes into this very easily. First element of the program, triple toe, right up into a double toe. He has good speed. It's so easy for him. He has good lift, nice air position. And this type of stuff is just out and out fun. And it's part of what makes Kurt Kurt. Who knows, though, compared to this group, how they will rate it. And you can see it's low. Those marks are low because it's more like playing and it's more like an exhibition program. But the crowd loved it. And, well, at least two of the judges acknowledged that it had some technical merit in it. But the presentation, well, what can you say? He's a show off. He loves it. He loves to entertain. It's about just being out there before the people. Elvis Stojko, one of Canada's heroes of the present day. He's struggled these last few years, and he's just coming back for what he hopes will be a great season. He now works with Uschi Kessler exclusively, no longer with Coach Doug Lee in Canada. He's skating to the Lion from the Best of Kodo. Quad toe with great height. The only problem is he drops his back on the landing, I think because there's so much power in the jump, and when he comes down with tremendous force. But it's a great way to start out the program. Trouble on that triple axel, he just didn't seem to check the landing. Well done, triplets. He is Canadian, we are up in Canada, and audiences love him. He is very focused, and I think that is due to his training in the martial arts. It has taught him a lot about discipline and strength and focus and centering. A lot of speed in those spins, which should be accounted for in the technical scores. And I think he's really improved upon the speed in which he moves on the ice. I've never quite seen him this fast. Oh, that's an unfortunate lack of focus, I think, more than anything on that spin. Sometimes you just get ahead of quite at the end of the program, but maybe he was trying to push himself forward just a little too fast. Elvis Stojko hit all the big elements, had a slight break in posture on that big quad, but pretty much hit every element in this program. Here's that quad. He has great knee bend, nice reach. His upper body really drops on the landing of the first jump. This triple axle is where Elvis had problems. He gets nice lift, but he just doesn't get that free leg back, and his body's not ready to take the landing. A nice checkout is what he needed on that, a very strong checkout, and he is so strong. But he did hit a big quad with a combination, and it should show here in these required elements. The last judge is off base. That should have been well up into the fives. But certainly one of the strongest performances of the evening. And presentation, well, he is focused, he is continually trying to explore new avenues with music and his choreography, and I think he achieved it here tonight. It was a great skate for Elvis Stojko. So with the men's short program finished, the results are Elvis Stojko of Canada in first place, followed by Emanuel Sandhu, Kurt Browning, Brian Orser, Todd Eldredge of the United States, and Stephen Cousins of Great Britain.